My name is Sheng Zhong. I'm in the bioengineering department. So my lab develops technologies that enable us to observe molecular and cellular phenomena that have not been seen before. These include, for example, single-cell multi-omics technologies, AI technologies. And with those novel technologies, we generate big data from human specimen and patient samples. And we leverage modern AI to prioritize very specific concrete mechanisms, and we experimentally evaluate those mechanisms. And with proved novel mechanism, we aim to develop therapeutics to intervene. For example, Alzheimer's disease is impacting 1 in 9 people aged 65 or older. Unfortunately, 2/3 of those patients are women. And we developed technologies that would enable you to simultaneously monitor 3D genome structure, gene expression, RNA-RNA interactions, and RNA-chromatin interactions from human brain. And analyzing Alzheimer's disease brains and control human brains, we discovered a hidden hallmark of Alzheimer's disease, that is widespread dysregulation of transcription in the Alzheimer's brains. And we recently were able to prioritize and evaluate and validate a novel pathway leading to this widespread dysregulation in transcriptional control and developing a therapeutic candidate that manifested dramatic improvement in cognitive deficits in different animal models of Alzheimer's disease. So that article is coming out in Cell next week. We have a desire to improve live birth rate in IVF clinics. And the idea is to do it via minimally invasive assays. So we discovered that human IVF embryos secrete many extracellular RNA from within the cell to the extracellular space. Working with Dr. Irene Su, we discovered a technique that is able to sequence the entire profile of extracellular RNAs from a tiny amount of liquid biopsy, including IVF spent media. So Irene actually were able to consent more than 60 infertility patient families harvesting IVF spent media from more than several hundred IVF culture. And we applied this SilverSeq technology to profile these spent media, generating the comprehensive profile of extracellular RNA. And leveraging machine learning, we were able to develop biomarkers that can predict the embryo quality to the same extent as embryologists' ability through imaging-based assessment. With that, I thank you for the opportunity. It's been always a pleasure working with folks working on women's health.